call to order the regular meeting of the Board of Public Safety for the City of Chicago. We will begin by reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all. Need a motion to approve the regular meeting of March 9, 2011 without reading?
Move that we had. Second.
Roll call.
Richard Morrisville?
Accept.
Richard Chumzinski?
Accept.
Thomas Davis?
Accept. We'll move along to the start of the hour. Building Department report, please.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Mina Guzman, interim building commissioner. The first property I'm bringing up is 4907 Alexander. I'm bringing this property before this board for condemnation and demolition. The main structure was a scene of a fire which occurred back on October 31st of 2010. The main structure's roof has sustained severe fire damage, as well as the porch, which have partially collapsed. The garage structure roof system has completely collapsed, leaving remaining walls unstable. This property is in violation of Indiana Code 3679, the unsafe building law. It is an abandoned vacant property, and both structures have been found to be in an impaired structural condition, posing an immediate danger to the life, health, and safety of passersby and neighboring properties. I have provided photos for you to review, and they're attached to the notice, so if you'd like to look at those. The owner has failed and or refused to bring this property up to code and abate the unsafe conditions that exist. Notices to appear have been properly served upon the owner and interested parties via hand delivery, certified mail, and publication. Pursuant to the title search, Michael Stooksberry is the owner of record, and he has signed the return receipt, which indicates that he received the certified mailing containing the notice to appear. To date, I have not received a response from the owner. And it appears that he did not appear today. He's not in the audience.
Mr. Tewksbury? Michael Tewksbury? No reply.
So my recommendation is, as the property is further deteriorating and an immediate danger exists, the building department's recommendation is to issue an order to demolish. So I'm asking that the board affirm my order to demolish, giving the owner until April 7th, 2011 to comply. The order will then be published and served upon the owner of record and interested parties. It will then be recorded with the county.
Do you want us to take action now or wait until that next meeting?
No, you could take action on my order. What I'm asking is that I'm recommending that the board affirm my order to demolish, giving
do that today.
Mr. Stooksberry until April 7, 2011 to comply, yes.
And do you have that in the form of a motion, Madam Secretary?
Yes.
I move that we adopt that motion.
Okay. I second
it. Could you just read it for us so we have it stated clearly what we're adopting?
You know what? It's provided to the secretary, Ms. Olga Cosme.
Just by title, it'd be fine.
I'm sorry?
Just so she can read it by title.
Okay, yes.
Just basically, what, not all of the details, but just to.
Do you want me to?
The property address is 4907 Alexander. It's the main residence and the garage to be condemnation and demolition.
And is that it refers to the next meeting, to the April 7th meeting?
That work shall be completed no later than April 7th, 2011.
That refers to the paperwork?
Yes, that's correct. Yes. That's the order to demolish.
We can take the vote on that then. Fine. Okay.
Thank you.
That's your recommendation?
Yes. To proceed with demolition.
And give the owner condemnation demolition. We need a vote.
Make a motion to accept.
Second.
I'll second.
Motion on the floor is to accept the building commissioner's recommendation to demolish property 4907 Alexander. Roll call.
Richard Morrisrell?
Accept.
Richard Chumzinski?
Accept.
Tom Davis?
Accept.
The board accepts your recommendation.
Thank you. I just want to note, if the owner fails or refuses to comply with the order entered by this board, the city will then pursue demolition proceedings on the property. If the city proceeds to demolish the property, we will pursue collection of costs incurred by the city. Okay, so if we have to demolish it, if he doesn't demolish it by April 7th, 2011, then the city will proceed with demolition.
We expect you to do that.
Yes, and I'll keep the board apprised of the status. And the rest of them are pretty much statuses. 4429 Arbutus, we were called out by the police department. This property was secured by the owner, no further action by the building department. 3913 Carey, we received a complaint from the code enforcement department. Work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 3825 Catalpa, called out by the police department. Property secured by central services. No further action by building department. 2204 East Columbus Drive, that is the former Burger King. That was a field inspection. We sent out a work order to central services to remove the dilapidated sign.
Doesn't the city own that now?
No. No, and I don't recall, I haven't, I would have to look. I can advise you on that the next meeting. Okay. But I know the city does not own it. Okay, so at this time, no further action by building department. 3907 Drummond, called out by the police department due to a fire scene, intrusion by unauthorized person, property partially sealed, and a work order sent to central services to seal all openings. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 4221 Drummond Street, complaint received from code enforcement, work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 4721 Drummond, called out by police department, property secured, no further action by building department. 3729 Guthrie, complaint received by code enforcement, work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for services rendered by the city. 3504 Hemlock, complaint received by code enforcement, work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for services rendered by the city. 3508 Hemlock, this was an inquiry made by the board member at the February 23rd, 2011 meeting. Just to go back a little bit, it was a notice to vacate issued on this property back on February of 2011. A work order was sent to central services to seal additional openings after your inquiry. And there's, I believe, a total of six openings that were sealed. And again, we will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 3510 Hemlock, that was a field inspection. Work order sent to central services to reseal. Property has been resecured, and again, we will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered. This property, somehow they keep entering it. They keep opening, trying to enter, and they have entered, actually, because we continue to have, if you notice, we've had it on our agenda for the last couple meetings. So we'll continue to reseal that. And also 4847 Homerly, complaint received from code enforcement, work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 4845 Melville, inquiry made by, again, board member at February 23rd, 2011 meeting. Previously called out by police department to seal property due to raid. The property owner secured the building. And property has since been occupied, and there are no violations observed at this time. 3763 Michigan, complaint received from the fire department. And this is a notice of order to vacate an unsafe premises that was issued to the owners and the tenants due to the unsafe and hazardous conditions at this location. There was glowworm heaters being utilized as main source of heat, which is...
What kind of heaters?
Glowworm heaters that were being utilized as the main source of heat, which is in violation of the International Fuel and Gas Code.
Those are space heaters?
Those are wall heaters. I had the information at the office, but David, would you like to elaborate a little bit on that?
Is that a brand name, glowworm?
Yes.
And what, they're space heaters typically, or for small spaces rather than...
The glowworm heaters are basically used for like a garage, to temporary heat a garage for a couple hours, but they're not supposed to be used for main source of heat in an apartment building.
And that's what they're using.
Thank you.
Also, at that location, basement walls and ceilings were or are in deteriorated condition. The northeast side basement wall has bowed outward and is buckling. Property is required to be brought up to code prior to it being occupied. Property will be monitored by the building department. 4834 Ocott. I'm sorry, do you have any questions on that?
No. Okay. I do not.
4834 Ocott, called out by police department. Work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 3814 Parish, called out by police department as a fire and crime scene. Owner secured property. Property to be monitored by building department for repairs. 3817 Pulaski, order to demolish, issued back on, this is a update on the demolition, 3817 Pulaski. Order to demolish issued back on December 22nd, 2010. Proposals received and awarded to Acton Inc. Demolition commenced on March 22nd, 2011, and we anticipate completion within 10 days. Unsafe structures should be down by the end of today. 4011 Pulaski, called out by police department. Work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. 4738 Todd, complaint received from code enforcement. Work order sent to central services to seal. And again, we will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. We have two more. 4911 Todd, called out by police department. Owner sealed the property. No further action by building department. 4915 Todd, called out by police department. Work order sent to central services to seal. We will pursue collection of costs incurred for the services rendered by the city. And if you have no questions.
Just one question.
Sure.
Can you think of any properties recently where we recovered the cost of services incurred? Another, we have a legal right to put that lien on the property, but I'm just curious in terms of the light of the market and the economy,
yes,
whether we've had any, had some positive experiences.
Yes, we did receive a check from the county this past January. It was a substantial amount. I can provide the information and give you the details on that
from
the next
a few
meeting.
Properties or a single property?
This was from a couple years ago, and we did receive also for a demolition that was performed last year, and I believe the property address 505 West Chicago Avenue. We demolished that property, and we did recover
Do those tend
costs.
To be
That one, I believe it was residential.
Okay.
Yes. But I can provide that information. I'll give you more detail on.
It isn't to create more work. I'm just curious in the light of the economy whether, and I was thinking perhaps more of the residential ones in the middle of the block, whether it's not kind of an act of hope to file those liens, mm-hmm. but
we do. We go forth and file those liens, even if it's a board up, even if it's $200. We do file the lien, and we place that lien against as a special assessment against the property. And when they go pay their taxes, if they pay their taxes, we're hoping they do, then they would have to pay that
the lien as well.
Yes. Yes. And we also indicate that on the file. Well, we have a program. It's called the Munis program. It's like a tracking program. And we do flag those properties. And when someone comes in to, say, apply for a permit or to just do any type of transaction, building department transaction, that'll come up and show that there's monies owed on that property.
Is that the financial program for the city?
Yes, it is, the munis program, yes.
And that's one of its functions?
But that assists us in that manner as well.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Motion to accept the building commissioner's reports.
I make a motion to accept building commissioner's report.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call?
Richard Morrisroll?
Accept.
Richard Chumvinsky?
Accept.
Thomas Davis?
Accept.
Thank you.
There are no other items on the agenda to discuss? Questions by the board or other people present? No questions, I entertain a motion to adjourn.
So move.
Roll call?
Richard Morrisroll?
Adjourn.
Richard Chumvinsky?
Adjourn.
Thomas Davis?
Adjourn.
That concludes the meeting of the East Chicago Board of Safety.